I broke down. I couldn't go without coffee. That was like, I went like a whole half day. Especially when I saw that this problem had, this day had 17 problems. I'm like, I need some coffee. I know for certain that you'll never finish this in class. You'll never, ever, ever finish this in class. So it's your job, in if you didn't understand what happened in class, to come here and get some help. So hopefully this helps. Hopefully it's crazy. This can be some crazy stuff we're doing. Okay, let's talk about some finance. If you can understand money and how your money works, you might make some money someday. If you understand math, you're definitely going to be making some money someday. What color? Let's go with blue. Okay. Kathleen puts $100 into her savings account bi-weekly. Right? Instead of putting that money into a savings account, her friend Harry recommended that she place it in an investment account that pays 2.5% annual interest. If Kathleen takes Harry's advice and deposited $200 into an investment account each month, determine how much money she will have after 6 years. Say what? All right, let's do this. So, grab our calculator. So she's get. So where did the 2,400 come from? Well, that should be obvious. 200 times 12 equals $2,400. Now, why is it 200? Because she's doing $100 every 2 weeks. So $100 every 2 weeks is basically actually, she decided instead of going biannually, she decided to do two. I was going back. I was going to go bi-weekly. That's going to be 26 payments. Never mind. We're good. So it's $200 in an investment each month. So 200 times 1,200 is 20. 200 times 12 is $2,400 every year she's going to do this. Now, she's going to be like a millionaire. Not really. I'm just kidding. But she's going to have some money. It's pretty good money. That's a lot of money. All right. After 6 years. So let's see. We've got the $2,400 she's going to invest. And this is 1 plus 2.5%, right? So that's an increase. And then we just come over to our calculator and we go, okay, 2,400 parentheses 1.025. Parenthesis raised to the 1th. I don't really need the 1th. And I now have $2,460. So $2,460. Exactly. Wow, that's nice. All right, let's keep this pattern going along. Another $2,400 for the second year. 1.025 squared. If we calculated that and I went over to my calculator, I'd say, okay, 2,400. So now it's going to be the same thing, but now it's squared. 2,521.50. So 2,521.50. And then we're going to take third year, $2,400, another $2,400. 1.025 cubed. Same thing. Enter, whoosh, cubed, 2,584.54. And then we're going to take $2,400, multiply by 1.025 to the fourth, and this time I'll have, oops. Oh my goodness, what am I doing? There we go. Now raise to the pink. Come on, help me. Four. Follow the yellow dot. 2649.15. And then we got two more years left. 2,400 times 1.025 to the fifth. 2400 times 1.025 to the sixth. Delete 5. Delete 6. So 2715. 2715. There are other ways to do this problem, but this is the way I'm doing it. 38. Because I want to show you how we're going to use geometric sequences. And 2783.26. Now, in order to alleviate all the fun and stress, I'm just going to tell you what that adds up to, because we're going to be here all day if I add that up. It's 15,713.80. Whew! That was a lot of work. So I'm wondering if, and this is something that computer scientists deal with all the time, and this is people that write programs deal with all the time, is and mathematics is behind all of it. Is there a way we can represent this situation without having to do every single year? And of course there is. We can just take a summation of n equal to 1 to 6 of 2400. 1.025 to the n. And if I grab my calculator, now I'm hoping, I'm crossing my fingers, it's going to come out to be the same amount. So we're going to go into your summation. N 1 2400 parenthesis 1.025 parenthesis raised to the, where'd it go? N. And then I think we got to go to 6, right? 6 years? Oh, I don't have the right number. What did I do? Miss a number? 025. 15,783 cents. What do I have? 80? Oh. 1383. What did I say it was? 71380? Maybe I'm off. Maybe I go back up here and add these. Let's see. There's 9, 17, 23. So that's clearly got to be a 3. So that should be it. 15,713.83. All right. Is there another way? I think there is. If I use the summation formula, and you remember, where is that thing? It's up here, right? If I use, nope, that ain't it. There it is. My a sub 1, that would be my after my first year, correct? And then after my first year, so in order to use that formula, I believe what we would have to do, let me make sure, get back. Okay, what is this? I can't get to the right place. I keep going. Oh, I know. I just got to click on this. Ah, that's so frustrating. I don't know why I keep doing that. How can we represent the situation without calculating? So I think I can use this summation. So S sub 6 is equal to, now after that first year, we had what, 2460 minus 2460. So this was A sub 1. This was at the end of my first year. Remember, you need a first term in the sequence. And the first term in the sequence was, I mean, if I'm going to add all these up, the first term of my sequence was this one, right? So you needed to calculate that first year, 2460, 1.025 to the 6 all over 1 minus 1.025. And if I do this right, and I don't type these numbers in wrong, I think I get it. Control division. So 2460, that was after the first year, minus 2460 parentheses 1.025 raised to the sixth all over 1 minus 1.025, forgot the O, forgot the zero, 15,713.83. So it ends up being the same amount, $15,713.83. How much did she earn on her investment? Well, we got to figure out how much she put in. So she put in $200 a month times 12 months, and that's $2,400 times 6 years. let's see, 12,000, and that's 2,400, so that's $14,400. So she put in 14,400, she got 15,713. So if I go to my calculator and I just subtract 14,400, that will tell me she made $1,313. So if I take the $15,713.83, I subtract off the 14,400, I get 83.3131. So $1,383.83. So the question says, did she make off more money? And that's hard to tell. But the answer is absolutely yes. And the reason being is, in a bank account, you're only going to earn like 0.9% interest. You know, this was 2.5% interest. So clearly she made more money. Clearly she may make more money. All right, let's get on to the meat stuff. Let's start talking. Problem four. Derek invests $300 at the beginning. Oh, wait. I gotta pause and I'll be right back. So Derek invests $300. Why can't I erase these? $300 at the beginning of each year in an account that earns 6% interest compounded annually. Derek would like to determine how much money in his account after 10 years. Use the sum of a finite geometric sequence to determine the amount of money Derek will have at the end of 10 years. All right, so sum of a finite sequence. First thing we got to do is figure out, oh, so the first year he's going to have $300. Oh, he's going to earn 6% though, right? So we're going to take $300 and we're going to multiply by 1.06 to the first power. And if I do that, what is that? Is that 318? Yeah, 318. It's $318. So at the end of the first year, I'll have $318. Now I'm going to use that sum of the sequence. We know A sub 1 will be, or the first one will be 318. So we go S sub 10 is equal to 318 minus 318 1.06 to the 10 all over 1 minus 1.06. So we grab our calculator, do a little bit of mathematics. 318 minus 318 parenthesis 1.06 parenthesis raised to the 10th power all over 1 minus 1.06. Kabam. 4191. 49. So the question says, to determine the amount of money Derek will have at the end of 10 years. At the end of 10 years, he'll have $4,191.49. Now, I'm just curious how much money he invested. He invested 300 times 10, so he invested 3,000. So he did all right, made $1,191. That's not bad. 6% is huge. What is an annuity? An annuity is a series of payments. I don't know why I keep using blue. Let's try going red. A series of payments made at fixed intervals of time. I have to talk about annuities with your car loans or your house loans or mortgages or college loans. We're going to have those, credit card payments, you name it, got an annuity. To find the future value of an annuity, sometimes you make it with an investment. We're going to use a geometric series. Or we can use this formula, where R is the reoccurring payment or deposit, and little r is the rate of interest. Find the interest earned and the future value of the annuity with the given annual payments and interest rate. So we're going to keep that formula sort of right there so we can see it. So annual payments of $1,200 for 15 years at 4% interest. So let's see. R is said to be what the reoccurring payment is. So that's capital R. This is little r. This is time. So let's see. A sub, how many years? 15. I should do A sub 15, not A, nah, A of 15 is equal to R, which is 1,200, parentheses. Now, this is compounded per year, right? So we're going to do this a little bit differently than we're going to have to do the other one. 1 plus 0.04 to the 15 minus 1 all over 0.04. Holy crapola. So let's see what that is. All this mess on my computer. So 1,200. Look down at my notes now. 1,200, parenthesis, control division, parenthesis, 1 plus 0.04, parenthesis, raised to the 15. Did I put raised to the 15? I almost feel like I forgot that. No, I got it. Minus 1. All over 0.04. And it's 24,028. So I get $24,028.31. So the question says, find the interest and future value of the annuity. Well, that's the future value of the annuity. The interest would be, let's see, if she made annual payments, so 1,200 times 15 is... No, it's 18,000, right? 1,200 times 15 is 18,000. So 18,000. So we got to figure out what the interest is by subtracting those. So we'll just take this one up here and we'll subtract this one. And so the interest was $6,028. So interest is $6,028.31. All I did was use the formula here and plug the numbers in. That told me my future value of my annuity. And then the 12 times 1,500, if she's making $1,200 payments every year for 15 years, that's 1,200 times 15. That's just $18,000. Now, this one is going to get a little funky. This one's going to get a little bit crazy. So you're going to have to follow me along. Why is this one getting funky? Oh, this one was annual payments. This is monthly for 31 years or 30 years. So these are like, this is like a mortgage payment. This one's going to get crazy. So even though this is my interest rate, that's my yearly interest rate. That's per year. And since this is a monthly thing, I'm going to have to account for that by choosing its like compound interest. So A sub 30 is equal to, now here's how we're going to account for it. We're making $865 payments times 1 plus the rate. Now, here's where the rate's different. Because it's monthly and this is a yearly rate, we have to divide by 12. So it's 0.04625 divided by, I could have picked a nicer interest rate, 12. So that was that piece right here that I just took care of. Well, that means that's got to be on the bottom too. 0.04625 divided by 12 minus 1. So the only thing new was this was a yearly interest rate and we were making annual payments. So it's 4% per year and we were doing annual. This is a monthly interest rate. This is a yearly interest rate, but we are doing this and making these payments monthly. So let's see how much money this is. So this one's going to look really, I'm going to get my screen all cleared up for this one. All right, so this is $865. Let me see. Let me go back over here and so I can see it. $865 times control division. This is going to get kind of crazy. Parenthesis. 1 plus. Oh, and I forgot the 30 over here, right? 30, right? Because it's to the T. So another control division. 0.04625 divided by 12. So now we have a monthly interest rate as opposed to a yearly. But we're going to do this for 30 years. Minus 1 all over 0.04625. Oops. Control division. Let's see if I can get that back in. Yes. 12. Whew. Man, make sure it looks right. Make sure it looks right. Does it look right? I think so. Let's see. Now, this should be a very large number. You're making $865 payments. This is like a mortgage payment every year for 30, every month for 30 years. That's a lot of money. And that's not the right answer. So what did I forget? I did it. I knew I was going to do it. I knew I was going to do it because I forgot this 30 up here and I knew I was going to do it. So let's go back to seeing what's going on. T is the, what does T represent? T represents the number of payments or time. But the problem with it is I'm doing this for 30 years, but this is monthly. So I'm not going to make 30 payments. I'm actually going to make 360 payments. That's 30 years times 12 months is 360 years. So normally if I was doing this yearly, I'd put a 30 there. But because I'm doing it monthly, and this is a monthly problem, I got to put a 360 there. Woo, I knew I was going to do that. I apologize, sisters and brothers. So we just got to go up there. I knew that number was not even close to being big enough, and I had to find my mistake. There it is. 360. Ah, 671,000. So A sub 30 is equal to 671,986.37. So the question says, how much of that's going to be interest? Well, if you made $865 payments times 30 years, well, every month, how about this, times 12, every month, times 30 years, how much money did you put in? Well, you put in 865 times 12 times 30. You actually put in $311,400. That doesn't seem right. $311,400. So how much money was interest? Well, we take this number and subtract this number, and I get 365.86. So 365.86. That's your interest paid. All right. All right, I'm going to pause now. I'll be right back. That one. All right, here we go. Let's move on. Let's see what we got here. Biannual payments of 6.5. Biannual. Okay, I don't think I meant biannual. That's always a confusion. Biannual usually means every 2 years. I believe on this problem I meant semi-annually. So hopefully I made that change. Semi-annually. Biannually, I think, means Every 2 years. We can Google it. How about this? Hey, Cortana. Hey, Cortana. What does biannually mean?
Biannually means adverb form of biannual.
Wow, that was useless. What does biannual mean? Hey, Cortana. What does biannual mean?
Biannual is an adjective meaning occurring twice a year.
Ooh, okay. I was wrong. So, I was right. I'll stay with biannual. It means twice a year. By the way, that's Microsoft's new Edge on Windows 10. I'm not making an announcement or an ad form. Okay, so here's what we got. We're going to go twice a year. Twice a year. They're giving you the yearly interest rate. So we're going to use that same formula. A of how many years? 10 years. Is equal to, so it's going to get a little tricky, $625, parentheses, 1 plus, now, it's 5.3% interest, so that's 0.053, but I'm doing it twice a year. The last one was 12 months. This one's twice a year, so I've got to divide by 2. Now, it's for 10 years, but I'm doing it twice a year, so this is going to be 20. And then I believe it's minus 1 all over that interest rate, which is 0.053 over 2, twice a year. All right, we got a big beast to put in our calculator again. Oh, all this mess. All right, so $625, so $625 payments, parentheses, control division, parentheses, 1 plus the interest rate, but divided by 2, because we're doing it twice a year, so 0.053 divided by 2, raised to the 20, and then minus 1, all over, control division, that's what I forgot to do last time, 0.053 over 2. And at the end of 10 years, I will have 16,000. So A of 10 is $16,208.70. So the question is how much was interest? So if we take 625, and we're just going to multiply by 20, because we know now it's twice a year for 10 years. 1350, what is that? 1250, 12,500? I think it's 12,500. Let's check. 625 times 20. $12,500. So we're going to take this amount, enter, and we're going to subtract this amount. I forgot the subtraction. And hit enter. And so we subtract these two. Subtract. And we get $3,708.69 in interest. If you think you understand money, I hope before you end this that you understand you should probably take a course in finance, because what you're going to find out is you don't know anything. And when you go to buy a car or you go to buy a house or you go to see a financial planner, you're going to get burned if you don't understand money. And money is not easy, and banking is not easy, and it's purposely complicated, you know? So you got to be careful. All right, let's keep moving. Weekly payments of $100 for 3 years at 7% per year. Weekly. What are we going to be dividing by in this one? If it's weekly, 52. So we're going to start with that same thing. A of 3 is equal to $100. That's our payment. 1 plus. Now 7% is yearly. We're not doing this yearly. We're doing this every week. So 0.07 divided by 52. Now, 3 years and weekly. So that's 52 weeks in a year times 3 years. That's 156 payments I'm going to be making. So that's what my new exponent is, 156, for 156 payments. minus 1 all over 0.07 divided by 52. Holy mackerel, these are getting fun to put in. Get a fresh screen again. So 100 parentheses, control division, parentheses 1 plus control division, 0.07 over 52 raised to the 156 minus 1 all over control division, 0.07 over 52. Woo! 17,356. So this is equal to 17,000. I should probably be putting these as 156. It's 150 weekly payments. So I shouldn't be using 3 years. I should be using that. $17,346 exactly. $346.00. And so how much money did they put in? Well, they put in 100 times 156. Now that should be pretty easy. That's 156 and two zeros. If we subtract 156, two zeros, 15,560, we get $1,746 in interest. There's my annuity amount. There's the interest I've made. All right, I'll be back. All right, kids, we're about to do it. We're about to do exactly what every kid wants to do. Yep. Buy a car. We're buying a car. All right, let's buy a car. I'm excited. Are you excited? I should have like a car emoji here or something with a big smile on it. So clearly annuities are very important in our daily lives, especially when you become an adult. And I'm telling you right now, understanding money is gi-freaking-normous. Buying a car is only one thing that most people need to do. Therefore, you should have basic understanding of the financial aspect. I will tell you right now, if you don't understand money and you go into a car dealership, guess what? You are going to get burned. Not badly, and they're going to be nice about it. They're going to be the most pleasant people in the world, but you're going to not get out what you think you got out. So let's see. Emily wants to buy a car for $12,000, but does not have enough money, just like everybody else. She goes to the bank to get a loan instead. Compute the future value of her loan if she finances her car for 4 years at 2.87% interest without accounting for monthly payments. So let's see. Her amount, this is interest on a $12,000 loan, 1 plus. Now she's going to be making monthly payments, right? Monthly payments. So that's 0.0287 over 12 raised to, let's see, 4 years. So 4 times 12 is 48. So she'll be making 48 payments. Oh, I should just put 12 times 4 up here because remember that's the formula? 12 times 4. All right, so if she does this and we type this in our calculator, oh man, I hate it when the calculator is messy like this. I don't know why. It's driving me crazy lately. 12,000 parentheses 1 plus point, what was that interest rate again? 0.287 control division, you're going to give it to me? Yes. 12, forgot to do that. Raised to the 12 times 4, 48. 13,457. So 13,457 dollars. $457.94. So how much interest will she pay? Well, if you take the $13,457.94 and you subtract off $12,000 minus 12, 1, 1, 2, 3, She'll make $1,457.94. Now, if you divide that by 48, divided by 48, every month she's paying $30 in interest. So just to take that loan is costing her $30 a month. Now, that's not even that bad. What if you did this for 6 years, a six-year loan? So right now, let's see what her monthly payments would be. In this case, so this is how car dealerships get you. This is what you're going to owe at the end of your time with the bank. So we take that $13,000 and we divide it by 48. And they say, okay, your monthly payments are going to be $280.37. So for 4 years, if you took out a four-year loan, your monthly payments would be $280.37. Right? And then what if they said, well, we can get that down. Let's do it for 6 years. So let's do the math for 6 years. I'm going to be a car dealer. I'm going to go do some magic, and I'll be right back. Okay. I gotcha. I understand. You can't afford that. So what if we go to a six-year mortgage? What if we go to a six-year? You could do a six-year loan, right? Six-year loan's not bad, right? Let's go to a six-year loan. So you can do a six-year loan. Look what we can do. We can get this down to $197.95. $197.95. What do you think? Can I get you in that car today? You're going to save almost $100 a month over that one. What do you think? Can I get you in that car today? You're like, wow, I can afford this. I can afford this payment. But what did you really do? So instead of a four up here, we're going to need a six now, because it's now 6 years you're going out for. Okay? So I did that math for you, and that's $14,252. So instead of this, it's $14,252.05. When you divide by 72, you get this. But how much interest are you paying? How much are you actually paying for that car? How much more than the car was valued? Remember, the car was valued at $12,000. So if I take that number and I subtract off $12,000, I get $2,252.05. So that car dealership made how much more money by this guy twisting your arm and getting you into a six-year loan as opposed to a four-year loan? How much more money did they make? Well, we're going to subtract off what the interest would have been the other way. 1,457.94. So minus... Escape. Minus, and I'm just going to go find that number. Where was it? There it is. Seven. They just made almost another $800 off you just by getting you to that six-year loan. And it cost you another $800 more for that car by them trying to get you in that loan. So you just got to be careful. All right, I'll be back. So annuities, just like car loans, require a monthly payment. So in order to account for payments, we need a new formula. The present value of an annuity consisting of N reoccurring payments and R dollars at interest rate. Okay. And I per time period. And so I is really going to be equal to my rate divided by how much I'm compounding. And we've already talked about this, right? If I'm compounding monthly or yearly, compounded. I'm going to divide by either 12 if I'm doing it monthly, 52 if I'm doing it weekly, 2 if I'm doing it biannually, now that we know what biannually means. I don't know why I have such an issue with that problem. So how much will each of Emily's monthly payments be over 4 years at 287? Oh, we got to go back to Emily's car payment. So how much her monthly payment's going to be? So She's taking out, let's say, the principal, the present value of the annuity is $12,000. We want to figure out what her reoccurring payment's going to be. So we got the R there. And then we got this crazy formula. 1 minus 1 plus. Now, this interest rate is the rate divided by the compounding. So in this case, because we're doing monthly payments, we're going to say 0.0287. By the way, the work I was doing previous was just a rough estimate. What did I come up with, by the way? 280. That's just a rough estimate. That does not, that neglects the fact that you're actually making payments. So we're going to, should probably be a little bit less when we're done. So 1 plus 0.02812 to the negative n. Now, what is n again? N is the number of reoccurring payments. So if you're going to go 4 years and you're doing it 12 months, right? That's what, 48? All over 0.0287 over 12. Now, do you have to memorize these formulas? Heck no. We got to figure out what that big mess is right there. So let's figure out what that big mess is. I don't know why am I bringing that up. I don't want you. Bam. So, ooh, messy. So, parentheses, control division, parentheses. Oh, not yet. Let's shoot outside. 1 minus 1 plus control division, 0.0287 over 12, because it's monthly. Raised to the negative 48 all over control division 0.0287 over 12. What is this number? It's going to be crazy. 45,296. So we don't want to round yet. We don't want to lose too many decimals. So we need R times 45. Don't round early, kids. You need all these decimals. 296,177, 8769. Well, how am I going to get R? Well, I'm just going to divide by 45,296,177,8769. And so I take 12,000 and I'm going to divide by this number. I'm hoping it's about right. Oh, 264.9. So her reoccurring payment is going to be $264.92 to pay off this loan. Yay, I got it right. All right, let's keep going. Emily realizes she cannot afford that payment. How much can she afford if she still wants to finance for 4 years at 2.87? See, this is where an informed person can come. They say, okay, I only want to spend $200. So before you even go out looking for cars, you say, okay, I can afford $200 a month. And now you can use this mathematics to figure out, okay, what can I actually afford? And you can go online and do this, but is it right? Are you sure it's right? I don't know. So we want to figure out what she can afford. So that's A equals 200. 1 plus 0.0287 over 12. And she still wants to do it for 4 years. So that's 48 months. So 0.0287 over 12. It should be negative 48. Okay, so if we said we're going to lock your payments in at 200 and instead of to whatever they came out, 260, this should tell us how much money we are going to make. So all I got to do is take this thing, which I've already figured out, enter, and I'm going to multiply it times 12, over times 200. She can afford $9,059. So really what she should be looking for is a car worth $9,059 and 20, $0.54. This I already did in the calculator. That was that 45 number. I just multiplied by 200. That's what she can afford. She can't afford a car that's $12,000. So knowing what you can afford before you go into a car dealership is ginormous, okay? So they don't just start lowering the monthly payment by, you know, pushing the number of years you got to pay for it up. All right, using this formula, evaluate the scenario described before. Laura wants to buy a car, and she can afford $350 a month payments. She plans to take out a 60-month loan, that's 5 years, but really 60 months is what we're going to need, for a used car at 3.27% interest rate. Oh, I didn't even talk about interest rates. I had to go back and do that real quick. If you're interested a little bit more on some money, or maybe I'll do it at one of these points, maybe I'll do it in this problem. Let's see what we can afford. What price car can she buy? So let's say we need to know A equals, she can afford $350. It's 1 minus 1 plus. Now my interest rate is 0.0327 over 12. And we're going to do it for 5 years or 60 months. So this is negative 60 over 0.0327 over 12. So we got to type that beast in there. Let's get rid of all this crap again in my calculator. So 350. Parentheses. Now, if I was doing this, by the way, I'd create a form. Excuse me. 350. Excuse me. Parentheses. Control division. 1 minus. Parentheses. 1 plus control division. 0.0327 over 12, because we're doing it monthly, to the negative 60 power, that's 60 months is 5 years, all over control division, 0.0327 over 12. Enter. 19,000, she can afford $19,348.85. So that's, she should be looking at cars under $20,000 if she wants to get in there, okay? I'm going to get one of these ones that I'm going to show you where you get ripped off. 14. Jeff wants to buy a car. Well, let me pause. I'll be right back. We'll talk about Jeff when I get back. Ah, come on. So Jeff wants to buy a new BMW X6 for $60,600. I hope Jeff has a good job. He's going to make a down payment of $3,000 and will finance it for 48 months at a rate of 4.14% interest. How much will Jeff pay each month for his BMW? So let's see here. We got to figure out what his payments are going to be. So what's his loan amount? His loan amount is going to be $60,600. Minus 3,000. So he's going to take out a loan for $57,600. That's what his loan amount's going to be for. So we want to figure out what his payments are going to be. Let me break this in a bit of better place. $57,600. So that's going to be equal to his reoccurring payments. Now we got this big long formula. 1 plus this is 1 minus, one plus, now his interest rate is 4.1%, so 0.0414 over 12, raised to the negative 48, all over 0.0414 over 12. So we got to figure out what this thing is as a number. So that's what we need to put in our calculator. So, oh my gosh, control division. Why did that go away? So, control division, 1 plus parentheses, it's minus. Why do I keep putting plus there? 1 plus control division 0.04114 over 12 raised to the negative 48 all over control division 0.00414 over 12. Enter. So 44166. So 57,600 is equal to R times 44. Now again, we don't want to round early. 16618. 16618. 44645. 44645. Now, it really doesn't matter because I'm not even going to use this. I'm dividing by that, and I'm going to divide by that 44.1661844. So I'm going to take 57,600, and I'm going to divide it by this answer. And I get $1,304. So his monthly payments are going to be $1,304.17. That's how much money he's going to have to pay for this car. Wonder what the car is going to cost him. So times 48. 62,540. So $62,599.93. And we subtract off, how much was it? He was making 57,600. So subtract off 57,600. Ooh, excuse me. Subtract off $57,600. And the car company, not only did they make money on the car, they make $5,000. They made $5,000. Just on the interest on that loan. So they made a ton of money on the car, plus they also made $5,000 on interest for that car. Woo! Now we're gonna have fun. So what would Jeff's payment be if he chose 60 months instead of 48? So it's basically gonna be the same thing. We did this before. We're gonna take 57,600. We're going to multiply by R times. Now, I'm not going to do that math. It's going to be that same thing. But this time, the only difference is instead of negative 48, we're going to use negative 60. So we're going to use the same calculator stuff. Enter. And we're going to choose negative 60. So now they've said, okay, you can't afford that. So let's go 60 months. So that's 54,113. So 54,113. Now remember, our payments are going to be lower because now we're going for 60 months. 233. And we're going to feel all good about it. 45. So now we're going to divide by that. 54.1132,33,45. Scroll down. So now we say, okay, let's take the fifth. Oops. Yeah, it's 57,600. Why am I not there? 57,600. And we're going to divide by this number we just came up with. Ooh. 1,065. So now R is going to be $1,065 and... $1,064.43. What's the difference in interest for the loans? All right, so first of all, I want to know what's his difference in payments. He was going to have to pay $1,304.17. Now he's going to have to pay this. So was $1,304.17. Now he's going to pay $1,065.43. I'm just curious how much money he's going to save. So 1,304.17 minus So now he's going to save $239.74. He's going to save $239.74 a month. It's not bad. That's not bad. So let's see what the interests are going to be. Let's see what my interests are going to be. So if I take 130417 and we multiply it by, what was that? We already did this work, didn't we? 48 months. I got 62,59,93. 48. I got 62. Oops. 599.93. Now let's take this one. 1065.43, and we're going to multiply by 60 months. So now we're going to take this one. Why do I have 65? It should be 64. 16443. This should be 4. Sorry about that, kids. Saved another buck. So it's really 40. So multiply by 60. 63,866.07 and 8 cents. So to that we're going to subtract. God bless it. Answer minus. 62,599.93. And it's going to be 12, so it's going to cost them an extra $1,266 in money. It's an extra $1,266 it's going to cost them. That's a lot of money. That is a lot of money. $1,200, an extra $1,200. So before they only made $5,000, now they're going to make $6,266 just in interest for you to buy their car. They make it money. Why do you think there's car dealers all over the place? Oh, my favorite subject, taxes. Oops, we forgot something. Uncle Sam wants his money. Yeah, you can't get away without taxes. Taxes will make the world go round. So just like when buying cars, or buying clothes, or almost anything else other than food, for the most part, unless it's prepared food, you have to pay taxes. You have to pay licensing fees. You have to pay destination charges. You have to pay delivery charges. You got to pay gas charges. You got to, oh, New York State charges, federal sales to 8%, and other fees that total about 2% of the sales price. Not only is you're going to have 8% cost, but then you're going to have about 2% of the sales price is going to be fees. Oh, man. All right. So Emily has decided to choose a car that costs $9,000. Let's go back to Emily. We're back to Emily. Hi, Emily. If you're Emily, hi. In order to keep her payments close to the $200 payment, determine with taxes and fees Emily's new payments. So let's see. First we got to do is take the 9,000 and we're going to multiply by 0.08. That's going to be our tax. So let's do that. Go over to our calculator. Why do all this stuff come up? I don't want this stuff to come up. Let's get rid of this. Control menu, clear it all out. 9,000 times 0.08, $720. So there you go. You got to pay another $720 in taxes. And then we're going to pay $9,000 times 2% for fees. So 9,000 times 0.02, that's another $180 in fees for a grand total of another $900. So now her car payment, she's not got a $9,000, even though she thought she was buying a car for $9,000, it's really going to cost her $9,900. That's like a 10% increase, basically. So let's see. We want to figure out what her payments are going to be. So we're going to use the same formula. 1 minus, I got it right that time, 1 plus, what was her interest rate again, I believe? Was it 2, I think it was 2.37, 2.87. Her interest rate, Don't forget, our interest rate was 2.87%. So 0.0287 over 12. And remember, she was doing it for 48 months. Over 0.0287 over 12. So let's see here. So parentheses, control division, 1 minus parentheses, 1 plus control division, 0.0287 over 12, parentheses, to the negative 48, all over control division, 0.0287 over 12. Enter. And I think that's the number we came up before, but now we're going to take 9900 and divide by that number that we came up with. And now her monthly payments are going to be $218. So now her reoccurring monthly payments are $218.56. So every month she's going to have to pay an additional $218.56 just to pay off Uncle Sam. Oh yeah, don't forget insurance, maintenance, fuel. Cars are the absolute worst investment. They cost you and cost you and cost you and cost you. It's better to invest in your education. Oh, Jake needs a loan to get in his freshman year of college. He needs to finance 30 G's. Woo! Over 10 or 15 years. Luckily, college loans are deferred as long as he is a full-time student. That is not true. Some loans, by deferred, they mean you don't have to make payments. You're still paying interest. So the monthly payment Jake will make if he finances for 10 years. So let's get going. 10 years. Jake. So what will his monthly payment? So we know we got to make a $30,000 loan. So that's what we're going to end up paying. We want to know what his monthly payments are going to be. So it's 1 minus 1 plus, 10 years, 0.0575, and that's actually a really good loan. I know my son's in college. He's got like 7% interest loans over 12. Now, 10 years, these are monthly payments we're going to make. So 10 years times 12, that equals 120 payments. So this is to the negative 120, all over 0.0575 over 12. Whew. So I got to figure out what that is. So it's 30,000 equals R times some crazy number. Here we go again. Oh, what is that? So, control division, 1 minus parentheses, 1 plus control division, 0.0575 over 12, raised to the negative 120, because we're going to make 120 payments, all over control division, 0.0575 over 12. Enter. 91,100. So 91,100. Don't lose any decimals. 219. 111119. So I divide 30,000 by that. Take 30,000. And I divide by that number. And I get payments are going to be $329.31. And that's just to pay off the first year. So you can imagine if you are taking another $30,000 and another $30,000 and another $30,000, that would be $120,000. So let's change this problem slightly. So now you're going to take $120,000. Your monthly payments are going to be $1,317.23. So if you're going to go to school where it's going to cost you $120,000 to go, for the next 30 years, you're going to be making that much money in payments. What? Now, if you get a good job, it's worth it. The monthly payments Jake will make if he finances for 15 years. Now, again, for 15 years, things are going to change. Now, the only change is going to be is times 12. Now, we're going to make 180 payments instead of 120 payments. So we're going to change this formula only up slightly. We're going to go up here and we're going to change this to 180. The only change is now it's to 180. So it's going to be 30,000 equals R times 1 minus 1 plus point. Oh no, we're making two changes, right? The interest rate changed too. So this is going to be changed a lot. So my new interest rate is now 6.02%. So 0.0602 over 12. Now it's 180 payments all over 0.0602 over 12. So not only the number of payments change, but notice when you finance for longer, it's a higher interest rate. So let's see. We actually got to do this and change these suckers to .0602 and hit enter. And so it's $118.35. So 30,000 equals R times 118, 3519, 3519, 16626, 16626. All right, to save time, we're going to take 30,000 and divide it by that number. And you get $253. So R equals $253.48. Anybody want to know how much money he's going to buy, how much money he's going to cost him? Multiply that times 180. That's how much money he'll have put in. $45,626. That $30,000 loan that was a $30,000 loan has cost him $45,626 to pay back. Holy mackerel. All right. Part C. The number of payments Jack will make if he finances for 15 years but pays $100 extra each month. Wow. So we figured out he was going to pay $253.48, but now he's going to pay an extra $100 every month. So we want to figure out what the number of payments will be. This one is going to get ugly. This one's going to get crazy. So we know he's got to pay $30,000. Instead of $253.48, he's going to pay $353.48 times. Now, this is for 15 years, so it's 1 minus 1 plus 0.0602 over 12. To the negative n, 0.0602 over 12. We have to solve for that. What you talking about, Willis? Okay, so let's at least get rid of this 353.48. Let's divide by that. So we'll take, I'm going to need a definite clear screen for this. So we're going to take, actually, I think I need to take a break. Oh, yeah, I've been going for a while. I'll be right back to finish this problem. Okay, so the first thing we're going to get to do is get rid of that $30,000. So 30,000 divided by 353.48. So now we've got 84.87. Now, again, we can't round. Don't round yet. I'm going to go black because this one's going to get crazy. 84. You know what I'm going to do? Because, well, that's okay. It doesn't really matter. 84,807. Let's get off my screen. 84,870. 84.870. 4311. 418. Is equal to 1 minus. Now I'm going to figure out what that number is right there. I'm going to figure out what this number is right here. So 1 plus 0.0602 divided by 12. No, I'm not. I'm going to leave it just like that because that's crazy. 1 plus, I thought it was going to turn out nice, 0.0602 over 12. To the negative n, all over 0.0602 over 12. So, how am I going to get rid of some more stuff? So I want to get rid of, the next thing I'm going to get rid of is this down here. So if I multiply this side by 0.0602 over 12, all over 1, and I multiply this side by 0.0602 all over 12. These will cancel. These will cancel. So I'll end up with, let's do that, this thing, enter, times 0.0602 over 12. 0.452, so this is 0.452. I probably should have left these all as fractions. 4257, 6666646, and I'm glad it was 4. 2895 is equal to 1 minus 1 plus 0.0602 over 12, all to the negative n. Anybody having fun yet? Oh, we just get to add one. Oh no, subtract one. So we'll subtract one. So, minus one. So, negative point. I'm running out of room. I'm going to have to draw smaller. Give me to change colors. Negative 0.5742333 4233337153715 is equal to negative 1 plus 0.0602 over 12. Well, I got negatives on both sides, so I can divide by negatives. I'll just make them both positive. So, finally, we get to, it's all about that base, about that base. You knew we had to get there because we have an exponent that we don't know. So, it's going to be log, all about the base. My base is 1 plus 0.0602 over 12 of, and then these two things are going to switch, 0.5742333 7105 equals negative n. So hopefully we come out with a negative answer. Otherwise we did this wrong. So control log parentheses 1 plus control division. It's going to get funky. 0.0 over 12 of 0.5742333 7105. Enter. Negative 110.85. So negative n equals negative 110.85. So really n equals 110.85, which is really about 111 payments. So it looks like he's going to have to make about 111 payments. Anybody have fun? I had so much fun with that problem. How much time? Did that take a long time? That didn't take too long. We have one left? All right, I'm going to pause because we've got one problem. All right, here we go. Last price. The median house price in the United States is approximately Oops, I had a highlighter. 51,700. Most banks will finance mortgages for about 30% of their salary. So if you want to go for a mortgage, they'll mortgage it out for about 30% of your salary. Although the down payment is not necessary, it's wise to save and put 10% of the purchase price down. Okay. Kira, an occupational therapist. Do you ever see those shows that says their budget is? Well, this is how they kind of figure out their budget. We can pay 30% for a monthly payment. So we're going to figure out what is the max price that Kira can spend on a house. That's what they do on all those shows. That's why people lose their houses, because they overextend themselves. Never should you be paying 30% of your salary for a house. It's just you bought too much house. But that's what they'll do. So let's see. We're going to take $59,950 and we're going to multiply by 0.30. This will tell us how much money Kira can afford every month just for her mortgage payment. Remember, this is just the mortgage payment. So $59,950 times 0.3. She can afford divided by 12. She can afford $1,498.50. Why do I have $4,970? Did I put the wrong price? Oh, nine. Is it 550? $59,500. Oh my gosh, I keep putting the wrong number in. What is this? I'm getting tired. $59,500. So $59,500 times 0.3. That's how much of her salary she can afford to pay the mortgage yearly. So we got to divide by 12. And now we know that she can afford $1,487, $1,487.50 every month. So now we want to figure out what is the biggest mortgage she can get approved for. Again, this is a bad idea, but I'm just telling you. So we're going to say, okay, what is my final payment? If we're going to make payments of $1,487.50 a month, so 1 minus 1 plus 0.0344 over 12, 0.0344 over 12. Now, 30 years, 30 times 12 is 360, right? So this is to the negative 360. Let's figure out what she can afford. So we're going to take that number and we're going to multiply it by control division. 1 minus parenthesis 1 plus control division. We've done this a few times. What was that interest rate? I don't want to write it down. 0.0344 all over 12. I almost went 4444. Call them if you need help. Raise to the 360 all over control division 0.0344 over 12. Now we're going to see what she can afford. She can afford a house worth. Oops. You see, I forgot a really important thing. I forgot the negative up here. Negative. That's important. 333. She can afford a house worth $333,743.07. I'm going to tell you right now, if you buy a house like that, you will be broke for the rest of your life. But that's what she can afford based on what the mortgage says. Let's say she only wants to finance for 15 years and the bank gives her a lower interest rate. What is the mortgage amount of the bank will approve her for? So we're going to do that same thing. We're going to do that same thing, but in this case, we're going to do $1,487.50, 1 minus 1 plus 0.0275 over 12. Again, whenever you go for a lower, in this case, when you go for a lower years, they're going to give you a lower interest rate, 0.0275 over 12. But we got to figure out what this number is. And 15 times 12 is 180. So it's negative 180 this time. So we're going to do that same thing. Let me see if I can copy most of this. Negative 180. And my interest rate's going to loan. Was it 7.5? 2.75? 2.75. 275. Now let's see what she can afford. $219,194.31. Don't do that. Don't max out. All those shows that say their max budget is blah, blah, blah. No, that's a bad idea. Don't do it. Okay, guys, that's money. I hope you at least got a little bit more of an appreciation for loans, car payments, bank statements, all this stuff. Not bank statements, but oh my gosh. Don't forget, we still got to play property tax and insurance. Oh my God, we're going to be so broke. Get a good job and don't overpay for things. Try not to take out loans. That's it. We're done. Catch you guys on the flip side. Bye.